Still Almost by Sacha Guitry. Today, with the students of Grade 9 Literature Class, we will be presenting the drama Still Almost. Let us see the first scene in Juliette's house. Juliette and her maid are discussing about selling the villa. There's a board called Still Almost put up in front of the house, but no customer came to buy. Here is Juliette and the maid.
Won't let her be sorry.
Not at all. Mind you, if someone had bought it on the very day I placed it for sale. But the sign has been hanging on the gate for over a month now, and I'm beginning to be afraid that the day I bought it was when I was very young.
All the same, madam, when they brought you the for sale sign, you wouldn't let them put it up. You waited until it was night, and then you went and hung it yourself, madam.
I know. You see, as I said, they couldn't read it in the dark, the house would belong to me one night more. I was so sure that the next day the entire world would be fighting to purchase it. I thought I would get 200,000, but I suppose I must cut my loss. Mom said, up with this first, because nobody really wants it. Anyway, what time did those agency people say? The lady would call.
Between 4 and 5, madam.
Then we must wait for her.
It was a nice little place for you to spend the weekends, madam.
Yes, but times are hard and business is bad as it can be.
In that case, madam, is it good time to sell?
It would be funny if I couldn't manage to sell a place here. A stone's throw from Jewel in the French Hollywood, and all I'm asking is paltry 100,000.
Madam, you know that I'm going to act for the cinema. So, madam, please, will you be kind enough to let me off tomorrow? They are giving me 100 francs.
Oh, it's unbelievable. How lucky you are.
Madam, they want a book in the film as well. So, they asked me if I knew of anybody suitable. So, especially madam, you have such funny face. Would you like me to get you the engagement? You will get 800 francs.
Thank you. I will. I'm going upstairs for a moment. If that's the lady, tell her I won't be long. It won't do to give her the impression that I'm waiting for her.
Very good, madam.
Couple are coming to see the villa. Let's see if they really buy the house.
I told you before we crossed the road that I didn't want it. As soon as you see the sign of villa for sale, you have to go inside and be shown it.
But we are buying a villa, aren't we?
We're not.
What do you mean? Then you are not looking for a villa?
Certainly not. It's just an idea you're stuck in your head for the past month.
What do you talked about nothing else?
You mean you talk about nothing else? I never talked about it.
Whether I'm looking for it, we are looking for it. The one thing that matters anyway is that I'm looking for it for us.
It's not for us. It's for your parents. You are simply trying to make me buy a villa so I can put your mother and father in it. You see, I know you.
Then why have you been looking over villas for the past week?
Oh no, I have not looking over them. You have, and it bores me.
Well, then stop being bored and buy one. That will finish it. We won't talk about it anymore.
That's exactly what I told you at the door.
In that case, let's go.
By all means.
What on earth will the lady think of us?
I have never cared much about anybody's opinion. Come along.
Good afternoon, madam. Monsieur.
How do you do, madam?
Good day.
Won't you sit down? Is your first impression a good one?
Excellent.
I'm not in the least surprised. It is a most delightful little place. Its appearance is modest, but it has a charm of its own. I can tell by just looking at you that it would suit you admirably, as you suit it, if you will permit me to say so. The house possesses a great many advantages, electricity, gas, water, telephone and drainage. The bathroom is beautifully filled and the roof was entirely repaired last year.
That is very important, isn't it, darling?
For whom?
The garden is not very large, it's not long and not wide, but...
My word, it's high.
That's not exactly what I meant. Your husband is very witty, madam. As I was saying, the garden is not very large, but you see, it's surrounded by the other gardens.
on the principle of people who like children and haven't age can always go live near a school.
Please don't joke, Gaston. What this lady says is perfectly right. Will you tell me the price you are asking for the villa?
Well, you see that I don't want to sell it anymore.
Well then, there's nothing further to say about it.
Please, I...
Let madam finish, darling.
Thank you. I was going to say that for exceptional people like you, I don't mind giving it up. I can say with the perfect assurance. Yes, I agree. I will sell it to you.
What's the price, madam?
You will never believe it.
I believe in God and so you see.
Entirely furnished with all the fixtures, with the exception of that one little picture signed by Kurt. I don't know if you have ever heard of the painter, have you?
Never.
Neither have I, but I like the color and I want to keep it if you don't mind. Villa itself, just as it stands, 250,000 francs. It worries people like yourself than giving it up, even for more money. The price must seem...
decidedly excessive.
Oh, no! Well, really, I must say,
quite so. Life is full of surprises, isn't it?
You think it dear at 250,000? Very well, I can't be fair than this.
If I did, I wouldn't be much less than that.
I tell you what I will do. I will be philanthropic and let you have it for 200,000.
And I will be equally good-natured and let you keep for the same price.
In that case, there's nothing more to be said, monsieur.
Good day, madam.
1 minute, darling. Before you definitely decide, I would love you to go over the upper floor with me.
I will show it to you with the greatest pleasure. This way, madam. This way, monsieur.
No, thank you. Really. I have made my mind that I'm not very fond of climbing stairs.
Just as you wish, monsieur. Shall I lead the way?
If you please, madam.
Juliette and Jeanne goes up the stairs while Gaston talk to himself. Meanwhile, the next customer, Al Smith, came. She assumed Gaston as the owner's husband, and Gaston uses his wicked mind here. Let's see what happens next.
200,000 for a few yards of land. She thinks I'm crazy.
See here, I tell you I'm in a hurry. Actually, how much should you pay for this house?
I don't know anything about it, madam.
Out of it, why is the present market signboard? Your French people have cute way of doing business. You go and tell your boss, if he doesn't come right away, I'm going. I have the time to waste. Oh, you're the husband, I suppose. Good afternoon. You speak American?
Sure, you betcha.
That goes by me. How much for this house?
How much? Well, won't you sit down?
I'm sorry, I don't think standing up.
Oh, do you?
Yeah, where is your wife?
Oh, she's upstairs.
Wow, that's good. Unless you have to consult the people you make a deal.
Me? Not on your life?
You're exceptional. Frenchmen usually consult about 10 people before they get a mobile. Listen, do you or don't you want to sell this house?
I? Oh, I'd love to.
Then, what about it? I have more than 5 minutes to spare.
Sit down for 3 of them anyway. To begin with, this villa was built by my grandfather.
I don't care down about your grandfather.
Neither do I. But I must tell you that...
Listen, you just tell me the price.
Let me explain that.
No.
We have electricity, gas, telephone.
Oh, I don't care. What's the price?
But you must go over the house.
No, I want to knock this down and build a bungalow here.
Oh, I see.
Yep, it's the land I want. After being a paramount, well, I'm gonna shoot some films.
Oh.
You see? I'm a big star.
Not really.
Yes, how did you? Well, not much.
Now let's see. In that case, entirely furnished, with the exception of that little picture by an unknown artist. It belongs to my grandfather and I want to keep it.
You simply said you don't love your grandparents in Europe.
We have had them for such a long time.
You forgot quite. You think about the past of the time. For we always think about our future.
Everybody thinks what he got.
What a pity. You don't try and copy as well.
Copies are not always good. We could only imitate that the imitations are no better than the parodies. We're so different. Think of it. Europeans come to America to earn money and Americans come to Europe to spend.
It's the same. You have to learn how to do business.
We are learning now. We're practicing.
Well, then how much?
Oh, the house. Let me see. I should say 300,000 francs. Same for everybody. Even though you're an American and I wouldn't dream to raise in the price.
Treat me as soon as anybody. Then you said 300,000.
Sincerely, about I love you, dear.
Say you? What are you doing me for?
Sorry, that's Shakespeare. I mean cash.
Oh, now I get you. Cash down. Say, you're coming on.
Wait, I never knew where they put my pen and ink.
Let me tell you something. You'd better buy yourself on it, but with my good feather. What the date is today?
It's 24th.
You can fill in your name on the check yourself. Oliver, retail designer. I'm a lawyer is,
Who?
Exactly.
What?
Hi, it's Mr. Hero. Fire the Kanban. He'll get in touch with you about the rest of the transaction. So, goodbye.
Goodbye, madam.
Just a second. When are you leaving?
Well, I don't quite know. Whenever you like.
Make it tomorrow. The market can't come on Thursday. So, goodbye. I'm very delighted.
Delighted to hear it, madam. It's very good thing in business when everyone is delighted.
So, all of you saw that Gaston thought it was not his house. He used his witty mind and sold it to Miss Al Smith. Meanwhile, Juliette and Jeanne came down after seeing the house. Let's see what Gaston does next.
Well, of course, it's very charming.
Of course, as I told you, it's not a large place.
Well, now, that's something.
You are quite right, darling. Thank you, madam. We don't need to keep you any longer.
Oh, that's quite all right.
Just a moment. My dear, you said that there are two large bedrooms and a small room.
Yes, and two servants' rooms.
Oh, there are two servants' rooms in addition, are there?
Yes.
Well, that's excellent.
Stop joking.
And the bathroom? What's it like?
Perfect. And there's a bath in it.
Oh, there's a bath in the bathroom, isn't it?
Of course there is.
That's all very important. While you're upstairs, I was thinking a lot about your papa and mama. You see, I'm really unselfish. I was thinking, and this is serious, about old age. You said 200,000 francs, right?
What on earth have you done?
Just trying to please you, darling.
Yes, 200,000 is my lowest. Cash, of course.
Well, that's fixed. I won't argue about it.
But there are so many things to be discussed before.
Not at all. As I'm not arguing about the price, as I'm not bargaining with you, you must allow me to keep this little picture which has kept me a company while you and my wife went upstairs.
Very well. You may keep it.
Thank you, madam. Will you give me a receipt, please? Our lawyers will draw up the details of the sale. Please fill your name. Let us see, it's 23rd, isn't it?
No, the 24th.
Ah, what does it matter? One more day or less.
Thank you, Marshal.
Good day, madam. Oh, by the way, you'll be kind enough to leave tomorrow morning, won't you?
So soon?
Well, say tomorrow evening at latest.
Yes, I can manage that. Goodbye, madam.
Good day, madam.
I'll take my little picture with me, if you don't mind.
Very well.
What on earth are you driving at?
I made 100,000 francs on a carat.
But how?
I'll tell you later.
Juliette and Gaston exchange a visit and check with each other. The villa now belongs to Gaston, who has made 100,000 francs by his quick wittedness and cleverness. Gaston says Juliette to vacate the villa by the next day positive and leaves the place. At the end, everyone was happy.